Podman and Bootc are coming home.
A somewhat newer project, but really it's been in the development probably for the last 10 years. It's called Bootc. And Colin Walters is the father of that, so why don't you tell us about a little history of Bootc?
We've been working on underlying technologies for many years. Bootc has a sort of core of OS Tree, which has been deployed for a long time, but we're taking it and making it a container-native front end as a way to manage the operating systems and really trying to drive container technology deep into the heart of the OS and create an experience where you can take those skills and use that to manage your OS.
So I've heard that Bootc stands for Bootable Containers. So how exactly do I boot a container?
No, it's an awesome question. So something that's really important to me is that the container is the source of truth. Now, when you talk about how a Linux system boots, well, if you're talking about, you know, virtualization, then often you start with a disk image. You know, you have, yeah, like a virtualization specific type disk image, maybe that's an OVA or an AMI or equivalent. But with Bootc, what we want to do is have the container image be the source of truth. So you go and you build your container image, and you can make a disk image out of that. So that may be what you want to do to bootstrap is, but the cool part, right, is that when you go and make a change, the container image is a source of truth. You don't have to go make a new AMI or equivalent. You don't have to think about that. It doesn't have to be your world.
Where do I get the kernel from?
Yeah, it's a great question. So the kernel does come from the container. In fact, also the bootloader and everything else. So when container images are basically tarballs with JSON, right? They're files. To boot a Linux OS, you need a file system and you need a bootloader. And you can create that when you make a disk image. But one of the things I like the most is Bootc. There's a verb called Bootc install where the container image can install itself. If you give it a blank file system, the container knows how to make itself bootable. Like the kernel comes from that container, the shim or bootloader, all that stuff comes from the container.
And can I also run it just as a container? Can I, you know, test it as a container before I actually put it onto the hardware or onto a virtual machine?
Absolutely, absolutely. That's a key aspect. So especially being able to run it and inspect it as a container image lets us leverage security scanners and other tools that are container native. So yes, you can run it as a container and check the contents and see what's in there. And you can even test some of your operating system without even booting it by running parts as a container image.
I think it's really cool that, you know, the place where you store your containerized applications is at an OCI registry, and now we're able to store our operating system, our entire operating system for a fleet of hundreds of thousands of machines, and I store that at OCI registry as well, like Docker Hub or Quay or Artifactory or any one of those tools. Very nice.
Thank you. Yeah, it's been a lot of fun to build this and to create that experience exactly like you just said, where the system administrator can see in their CI/CD pipeline the build and flow, go to a registry, and then, you know, do blue-green deployments by having different tags, you know, like a blue tag and a latest tag in your registry, and know that your operating system rollout is just going to use that as a source of truth. You can just think about and visualize from a registry.